Have you ever considered levitation a superpower? It's super science. Let's find out why and how you can levitate a frog.
Unbelievably, something like water can be just as magnetic as iron.
There are 5 types of magnetism: ferro, para, dia, anti-ferro, and ferrimagnetism. Can you guess which one we can use to levitate stuff?
Diamagnetism. This uncommon form is only measurable if there are no other magnetic effects present. Almost every material exerts it, but the force is usually so weak it is unnoticeable.
Diamagnets have atoms with paired electrons and are repelled by both ends of a magnet. Diamagnetic behavior changes the orbit of an electron in the opposite direction due to a magnetic field. Take the SC maglev trains. They use superconductors to travel at 600 kilometers an hour whilst levitating with zero resistance. Superconductors need to be cooled in order to run along a track indefinitely. You can change its orientation, speed, and load without derailing it due to quantum locking. Take this frog. On the surface, we wouldn't think it has any magnetic properties, so we change perspectives and zoom in on the microscopic level. The frog is made of millions of water atoms. They become magnetized and are repelled by a large magnet. We have essentially built an anti-gravity machine, as the gravitational force is compensated on the level of individual atoms and molecules. So the frog floats, meaning that instead of sending experiments to space, we could study the effects of microgravity with a magnet. Now you know how diamagnets can be levitated. You could find yourself a powerful enough magnet and achieve self-levitation.